Hello, and welcome to Marriage Minutes, where we look at the government's plans to change the real meaning of marriage. One of the things that's been so shocking about this whole issue is the way the government has been ramming this bill through Parliament. Every shortcut has been taken. When this bill was first debated in Parliament, MPs were only allowed 4 minutes each to discuss it. That's just 240 seconds to talk about sweeping away thousands of years of history. And while the major parties promised a free vote, there have been persistent stories of behind-the-scenes arm-twisting. In a confidential poll, 27% of Conservative MPs admitted it was not a genuine free vote. And that's just those who are willing to say so. One MP who opposed the bill was even threatened with blackmail. It's appalling to pressurise people's consciences in that way. After an initial debate in the Commons, detailed consideration of the bill was shunted off to a committee. An issue as important as redefining marriage should be considered in depth by the whole House of Commons, not just a committee. And that committee was stacked full of the bill's supporters, 15 of them, compared to just 4 opponents. When the bill eventually returned to the whole House of Commons, MPs had a debate about protecting people who believe in traditional marriage. But that debate was restricted to just 2 hours and 15 minutes. The very next day, double the time was allocated to discussing humanist weddings and transsexual benefits. You know, 10 years ago, the government allowed MPs to spend nearly 100 hours debating fox hunting. But now, MPs have had only half that time to debate the redefinition of marriage. It just shows the contempt in which this government holds marriage. Whatever side of the debate you're on, surely we should all agree that this is a big issue which deserves proper parliamentary scrutiny, not this reckless haste.